Every great war has its heroes. I'm just curious what kind you'll be.
As of this moment, I declare the Inquisition reborn.
All right, here we go. At long last, I'm sure for a few of you anyway. Hopefully some of you are looking forward to seeing this on the channel. I've been looking forward to getting it up here on the channel. I've been putting off doing it, for a couple of reasons. One, I've been trying to get other stuff moving at a good rate of speed here on the channel. I've also been waiting for a patch to kind of address some of the control issues with the game. Interface issues, stuff like that. Clearly, it was more designed more for console and controller play, and hopefully, some tender love and care is given to the keyboard, mouse and keyboard users on PC as well in upcoming patches. But you know what? I sat down with the game and I had played it through the prologue, and then I just let it sit for a little while. Then I got back in, started a new character, did it yet again, and went beyond the prologue and just got hooked to the gameplay, loved it, and I thought to myself, if I don't start this series, if I don't start over and start this series soon, I'm gonna play through the entire game before even, before without capturing anything, And so I thought, okay, I gotta stop, and we'll get this series kicked off, and here it is. Now I'm gonna shoot for longer episodes with this series in particular, and it's gonna be a lot of those moments where we're talking with characters rather than fast-forwarding or editing out, the city experience, the crafting experience. I think you'll see much more of that in this game. I'm looking to go at a nice kind of just not in your face pace with this. Get to showcase a little bit of everything. Those of you that have been watching my stuff for a while, you know that I like to wander through the game world and get a lot of stuff done, completionist style. You're gonna see that here. There's gonna be a lot. I'm not focusing on just running straight down the main quest line. We're gonna be branching off and doing a lot of the side work as well. So hopefully you're looking forward to that, and you don't mind that. That's what's coming with this. I'm gonna start up a new game here, so let's get things rolling. Alright, and I'm pretty sure with that, I have sealed, tossed away all the progress I made with that last character, which is fine. We'll do it again, we'll do it better than before. What I had decided on, I think, was Kunari. Now, I'm not well-versed in Dragon Age lore, even less than I am with Elder Scrolls. Elder Scrolls, I'm not too bad with it, but with this, I mean, there may be personalities that should be present in specific races that I just won't portray well, in my decision making out there. So don't hate on me, for you Dragon Age purists out there. Don't browbeat me, please. Anyway, gonna do a female. You can see she's up there, female Kunari, I think, and we're gonna be a mage. It really was a toss up between the elf and the Kunari, and I knew I wanted her to be magical in design. Of course, I do have my party members that I will be rotating through actively during the gameplay. So we'll go straight over to the mage, and we're gonna do it on hard. I'm not gonna risk nightmare. No, not for the playthrough, the broadcast playthrough. We'll do some hard action though, and see how that goes. I just wanted to throw this in here, a quick little edit, because I did skip through the character rundown so quickly. There were a few pop-ups that came in to help describe the person that we are, So, as the female mage Kunari, here's the rundown, the opening rundown. Followers of the strict religious philosophy of the Kun, the Kunari appeared like a tidal wave into the north of Thetis 300 years ago. You are Tal of Ashoth, the Kunari who has rejected the Kun and never even lived in the Kunari lands. You have earned a place within the Valo Kas Mercenary Company as its mage, possessing abilities that would have made you a pet, a slave among your own people, ignoring the fearful looks you receive from those around you. Most recently, the company was sent to the Chantry Conclave, hired swords meant to keep the peace, a task that has gone horribly wrong. All right, and I think that's pretty well it. It's just the default state that I want here. All right, here we go. Oh, good lord. She is something else. Here we go. Well, I think as far as this goes, I'm going to be here a little while. I'm going to have to figure something out with this. Because I could be here for the full 45 minutes that I'm slating out for this episode. if just kind of left to my own devices. So I'm going to probably shut the mic down. And I'm planning some sort of fast forward. Just a speedy edit, character creation, or a few edits here and there as well, you know. So, I'll see y'all on the other side.
To the sky for one day.
looking at it, I think we're there. I think I'm there, and I've been in here a while. You're definitely gonna get the condensed version of that. She's not looking too bad. I found with the Kunari, you gotta scale back that massive forehead that comes along with those horns. Otherwise, she looks all out of proportion. But she's looking pretty good there. At least I think so. Y'all may agree. You're entitled to your opinions. Let me know what you think. Is she worthy for the channel? I hope so. Anyway, that looks good. Let me just do one last test
here.
As long
as the job gets done, I don't care about
good.
The rest.
Yes. My sentiments exactly, my dear. Let's roll. Oh, and look at that. That's the default name. And you know what I like to do? We just throw a little T to the Z in there, and we make ourselves a little Herza. Yes, we do. Let's do it. I get in touch with my giant horny female side. Yes, the giant horny female within me. Yes. Goddamn. Get your minds out the gutter, people. Here we go. The cutscenes are the true test as to whether I did her justice or not. Is she a freak of nature, or does she look moderately well done? She's not too bad right now, you know? Not too bad.
Tell me why we shouldn't kill you now. The Conclave is destroyed. Everyone who attended is dead, except for you. You think I'm responsible? Explain this. I can't. What do you mean you can't? I don't know what that is, or how it got there. You're lying!
We need her, Cassandra.
Whatever you think I did, I'm innocent.
Do you remember what happened? How this began?
I remember running. Things were chasing me, and then a woman?
A woman?
She reached out to me, but then...
Go to the forward camp, Liliana. I will take her to the rift.
What did happen?
It will be easier to show you.
She doesn't look too bad. There are some moments where I've already noticed, you know, when the face animates and contorts and certain expressions, it just doesn't look right. I don't know. I don't think I've made a face yet that actually looked good across the board, you know. Anyway, what can you do?
We call it the Breach. It's a massive rift into the world of demons that grows larger with each passing hour. It's not the only such rift, just the largest. All were caused by the explosion at the Conclave.
An explosion can do that?
This one did. Unless we act, the Breach may grow until it swallows the world.
Ah! Ah!
Each time the breach expands, your mark spreads, and it is killing you. It may be the key to stopping this, but there isn't much time.
You say it may be the key. To doing what?
Closing the breach. Whether that's possible is something we shall discover shortly. It is our only chance, however. And yours.
Very well. I will, we'll help if we can, then.
I understand. Then, I'll do what I can. Whatever it takes.
Cassandra seemed completely, you know, taken aback by my compliance here. So, maybe we're proving ourselves worthy here. Down this dialogue path, with those decisions made.
They have decided your guilt. They need it. The people of Haven mourn our most holy, divine Justinia, head of the Chantry. The conclave was hers. It was a chance for peace between mages and Templars. She brought their leaders together. Now they are dead. We lash out like the sky, but we must think beyond ourselves, as she did. Until the breach is sealed. There will be a trial. I can promise no more. Come. It is not far.
Where are you taking me?
Your mark must be tested on something smaller than the breach.
All right, here we go. And you'll notice, I mean, I'm pretty quiet during the cutscenes, and I will be a lot for a lot of them, you know.
Open the gate. We are heading into the valley.
There's just so many lines of dialogue that do sprout up, and especially if the banner system is working properly out in the field, there's a lot of conversation that takes place. And I'm not gonna fight against the game, you know, to try and get my two cents in. You know, often in other playthroughs, some of you I'm sure are used to me running my own my own take on things in controlled character to NPC. Conversations and interactions, but you're gonna see a lot less of that here with this game.
The pulses are coming faster now.
All right.
The larger the breach grows, the more rifts appear, the more demons we face.
How did I survive the blast?
They said you stepped out of a rift, then fell unconscious. They say a woman was in the rift behind you. No one
woman.
Knows who she was. Everything farther in the valley was laid waste, including the Temple of Sacred Ashes. I suppose you'll see soon enough.
Yes. Just wanted to do one final check there. A little close-up shot. She was looking a little butch there from the one angle. Not that there's anything wrong with that. Just really not what I had been going for. But I guess it's hard to avoid when you've got horns and you tower over most other people. You know, Cassandra pretty confident in her own abilities, sir. But I'm confident in mine as well, yes. Get out of here, Shade. There's something that I've really... It took me a little while to get used to the controls, I have to admit. But there's something really addictive about this gameplay that I'm just loving it, you know?
It's over.
Drop your weapon. Now!
I think not. You need to trust me, Cassandra.
If you're going to lead me through a demon-infested valley, you'll have to trust me.
Give me one reason to trust you.
Because my life is on the line.
You're right. You don't need a staff, but you should have one. I cannot protect you.
Good. She reluctantly concedes.
I should remember you agreed to come willingly.
That's right. I think there's a bit of loot over here. I'm always on the lookout for it.
At the forward camp,
there we go.
We are on our own for now.
All right, the Rashvine Vitar. I don't have a clue. I'm only guessing with that pronunciation, as I will be, I'm sure, with many things in this game. Anyway, it's this here. For those of you unfamiliar, it's like a face paint that only the Canary can wear. It's crafted from a deadly poison and gives me specific effects, you know. So, plus 3 to attack, and I'll get that. You can see the markings are on her face now. Alright. There we go, looking sexy, my dear. Looking fine and deadly. Like you mean business, but you mean business with a smile. Yes, business with a smile. Alright, all these pop-ups are getting a little annoying, I have to admit.
If we flank them, we may gain the advantage.
Get out of here, shake! Alright, that went pretty well. Although we've hardly been tested yet. In fact, I'm feeling a little, like a little gimped right now, you know? I had a full party where I was at in the game, and several abilities unlocked. But we'll all get there yet again together, okay. The Shadow Essence, that is a creature material. Eventually that will be researched so that I can get gain strength and efficiency in combat against that specific creature. At least I think that's how it works. Come on, Cassandra, get in here. Do your job. I blew my flame spell a little bit early. Often the flame spell that I have right now, I can't remember what it's called exactly. What is it? Flash fire. It will panic. Has a chance to panic the creature that gets hit by it. And it'll get them off my case, you know. Back them up. Those damn wraiths, you know. Whatever it is they shoot at me, will it ever do a number quickly, you know? They'll chip away at you from a distance like that if you're not careful. But anyway, no matter. I've got some health potions. You can see them in there. Something's popping up. My biggest pet peeve, I think, just for basic controls, is the lack of a walk button. I've made mention of that in another video, I think something for Skyrim. I did say it. You know, I know other people, though, who were fans of the original games, are certainly, I'm certainly disappointed with the fact that they can't point and click for movements, you know. You bugger. But for me, I mean, I'm so comfortable with WSAD in it, you know, that I don't really mind it. In fact, I would prefer it like this, but I certainly understand where the longtime fans are coming from, you know, to have had something so familiar taken away from them. He's about done. That guy's been buffed. That wraith over there. Or he's got some sort of bonus shield. I'm not even doing any damage up there. Shots aren't getting through. There we go. The AI, the tactics, the tac cam, and there are other things that are a little sketchy in this, but I'll have plenty of time to discuss that as we play it. For the most part, I'm having a great time with the game, though. If you look past its flaws.
You can hear them fighting.
Who's fighting?
You'll see soon. We must help them.
Get out of here, sir. Back it up already. My friend Varric.
Before more come through.
Making a wonderful entrance.
What did you do?
I did nothing. The credit is yours.
You mean I did that? You mean the mark?
You mean this?
Whatever magic opened the breach in the sky also placed that mark upon your hand. I theorized the mark might be able to close the rifts that have opened in the breach's wake. And it seems I was correct.
Meaning it could also close the breach itself?
Possibly. It seems you hold the key to our salvation.
Good to know. Here I thought we'd be ass deep in demons forever. Varric Tethrys, rogue, storyteller, and occasionally unwelcome tag-along.
You with the Chantry, sir?
Are you with the Chantry, or...?
See?
Was that a serious question?
Technically, I'm a prisoner, just like you.
I brought you here to tell your story to the Divine. Clearly, that is no longer necessary.
Yet, here I am. Lucky for you. Considering current events.
That's a nice crossbow you have there.
Ah, isn't she? Bianca and I have been through a lot together.
You named your crossbow Bianca?
Of course. And she'll be great company in the valley.
Absolutely not. Your help is appreciated, Varric, but...
Have you been in the valley lately, Seeker? Your soldiers aren't in control anymore. You need me.
Ugh.
My name is Solas, if there are to be introductions. I am pleased to see you still live.
He means I kept that mark from killing you while you slept.
Then I owe you my thanks.
Thank me if we manage to close the breach without killing you in the process. Cassandra, you should know. The magic involved here is unlike any I've seen. Your prisoner is a mage, but I find it difficult to imagine any mage having such power.
Understood. We must get to the forward camp quickly.
Well, Bianca's excited.
Good. Good. Master Dwarf, yes.
This way, down the bank. The road ahead is blocked.
What I was going to say...
quickly.
Mid-conversation was that, you know, I can't, to say the line, is all, it becomes redundant, because, you know, it's just like my character's gonna say it anyway, so I just need to shut up during the conversations, for the most part. Alright, what did I pick up there? I grabbed the Acolyte Fire Staff, and it's, you know, fire damage. I want her to be more of a fire mage, you know, so, clearly, the staff should go along with that, and it does a little more damage, so let's... equip that sucker right there. Let's take a look up here. Yeah, one little bit of loot. Some gold, everyone's favorite. Alright, now I think I have full party control at this point. No, not quite yet. Not quite yet. I can't rotate through characters. Got a little something back here. This is kind of a hot topic. The having to search, you know, spam a button to try and highlight items on the map. Not everyone was too pleased to see that. I don't mind it. It's something you just kind of get used to while you're off exploring. Come on, get up there, Herza. There you go. Hopefully everybody's up with me. Doesn't look like it though. Okay, here we go. And let's get right into a little tac cam action. Okay. So I'm not gonna do a rundown. I'm comfortable enough with it. I don't need those pop-ups. What I want is I want my my warrior up front, holding her position there. We'll get Solas over there, holding the position. And we'll get Varric kind of sitting back with his bow. And of course, my darling right here hurts, huh? And there we go. Now, this is kind of one of my issues that I really don't like with the tac cam is that... Actually, are they all going to shift out of position now? Because I hit the wrong button. No, it doesn't look like it. Okay. Is that I have to... First, I have to control them all to their positions. And only then... Like, I can't give them multiple commands at once, which really bothers me. It just seems like I have to do far too much micromanagement, you know? But here we go. All right. So, enough dicking around. Let's just get right into things. We'll have him attack that fella right there. We'll have Varric work him over. And of course, there we go. And of course, they all push up, which I don't really like because they both have the range available. I guess they simply didn't have line of sight, you know, which is a shame because I thought we had a good setup going here, you know. So now I have to pull them back. We'll get Cassandra putting up a shield wall there. So she can just sit there and absorb the damage coming her way, you know? Alright, now we'll move Varric over here. And we'll move Solas down here as well. Alright, we'll get What's-Her-Face going after that fella right there. There we go. So you see the tac cam, a really basic encounter there. Not a lot going on, but there certainly is some use for it, you know. Some people live in the tac cam, from what I've been reading on the forums. They really enjoy it. I like going to it. I just wish it was a little bit more useful. I mean, it's not bad. I feel like often, having to do far too much micromanagement. I like the fluidity, maintaining a certain level of fluidity in the gameplay. You know, I certainly like initiating tactics and being able to control my party in such a way where time's at a standstill and I can take a second and figure out what I want to do. But when I have to go into the tac cam three times to get one person to kind of make one sweeping movement into a flanking position and then initiate a specific attack, you know, stuff like that, that kind of gets a little, it just bothers me a little bit, you know, that it has to, that it's not more user friendly. All right. There we go. We'll get What's-Her-Face there. Varric can, I don't know. We'll get him up there so he's raining down a little death. And Solas, yes. Ensure that the party, and the tac cam, not always the most intuitive, you know, of devices. Back it up, sir. My target here, people. Please and thank you. Certainly on me a little hard here.
I'm guessing you don't actually follow the Kune, do you? You're Talvashoth.
That's an excellent guess.
Well, you haven't recited a single quote from the Prophet Kusloon yet. So unless you're trying to stay on the Seeker's good side, I'd say that's pretty telling.
Okay, I think that's it. Just a bit of a dead end up here. But I certainly gained a little XP and grabbed a few items. In fact, that life ward amulet. I think let's see. When a blow is about to drop a character's health below zero, the amulet shatters and heals the character for the specified amount, which would be 50 health in that instance. There we go. We'll get that on the main dame, yes. The lovely Hertzda.
I know it's difficult, but we must keep moving.
All right. I'll get us as far as we can, or I can hear people, you know. I wish I could get us through the entire prologue, but I don't think it's gonna happen. I mean, I could. There's nothing stopping me from running this an hour long for the opener. Alright, let's move the mages up. Find a little bit of cover here. I may leave Solas back. We'll put Varric over there. And I'll take Cassandra in. Try and lure in the one Shade here. See, what are you doing here, Varric? You attacking anything? I'd like to move him right around on that one wraith, although I've lost him. I could have sworn there's a wraith up here. Anyway, I guess not. Unless Solas took it out, or maybe Varric did it in on its approach. Who knows? There we go. Maybe it fled in terror. I don't know.
I hope Liliana made it through all this.
She's resourceful, Seeker.
We will see for ourselves at the forward camp. We're almost there.
I love the breach in the background. I mean, it looks really great, you know. Gives it a real sense of scale. We'll get Cassandra taunting that fellow over there. Solas can freeze him up. And Varric can move over there. Oh, there's a Shade. Damn it. This kind of buggered this up. I didn't even see the Shade there. I don't know where they came from.
Hurry, use the mark.
Loving it. All right, and we gained a level, so some experience coming in.
The rift is gone. Open the gate.
Right away. We are clear for the moment. Well done.
All right.
Whatever that thing on your hand is, it's useful.
Well, clearly, Varric. Okay, do I grab a barrier here early on? No, I think I'll go straight over to a little fire action here. Okay. We don't need to see all of this. So flash fire is the ability I currently have, igniting an enemy with searing pain, send them fleeing in a panic. And we've got immolate over here, leash a massive explosion, leaving enemies in the area burning in agony. And it's got the detonator ability, use on incapacitated foes for a combo. But I've read in the forums that this, it may not actually work as a detonator, so it could be a bug. There are a few abilities that aren't actually doing what they say they're supposed to be doing that I would imagine will be resolved in a patch in the future. Anyway, let's grab Immolate here. And number 3 in the list, good. Alright, let's continue to trek forward a little ways here anyway. I don't think I'm going to get the full prologue in, though. There's still quite a bit to do. Grab that Morningstar. I think I'll give it to Cassandra. Let's see. Oh yeah, there's a big improvement there.
Here they come.
You made it. Chancellor Roderick, this is...
I know who she is. As Grand Chancellor of the Chantry, I hereby order you to take this criminal to Valroyo to face execution.
Order me? You are a glorified clerk, a bureaucrat.
And you are a thug, but a thug who supposedly serves the Chantry.
We serve the most holy, Chancellor. As you well know.
Justinia is dead! We must elect a replacement and obey her orders on the matter.
Isn't closing the breach the more pressing issue?
You brought this on us in the first place! Call a retreat, Seeker. Our position here is hopeless.
We can stop this before it's too late.
How? You won't survive long enough to reach the temple, even with all your soldiers.
We must get to the temple. It's the quickest route.
But not the safest. Our forces can charge as a distraction while we go through the mountains.
We lost contact with an entire squad on that path. It's too risky.
Listen to me. Abandon this now, before more lives are lost.
Did you see the smirk on his face? Monk. Really? Oh, it's up to me, is it?
Now you're asking me what I think.
You have the mark.
And you are the one we must keep alive. Since we cannot agree on our own.
Fine, if I have to make a choice, well, it'll be this.
Use the mountain path. Work together. You all know what's at stake.
Liliana. Bring everyone left in the valley. Everyone.
On your head be the consequences, Seeker.
I think I'm gonna wrap it here, all. Appreciate you stopping by for this opening episode. I hope you'll be back for some more. Whether I do a double shot here in day one for the Dragon Age Inquisition, I don't know. I don't know. But it's been a pretty long episode, I think, for the most part. And, well, we'll be up moving through this mountain pass next, and we'll be wrapping the prologue next episode as well. So be sure to stop on in, and we'll be setting off on our adventure from there.